thank you very much. Before my talk, I'd like to thank the organizers for kind invitation to this exciting conference. Title of my talk is Quantum Degenerate Mixture of Alkali and Alkaline-Earth-like Atoms. I'm Takahashi from Kyoto University. This is outline of my talk. First, I briefly mentioned the unique properties of yttrium lithium mixture. And then I will describe in detail our recent experiment of realization of quantum degenerate mixture of yttrium and lithium. And finally, I will discuss the prospects of our research. And our target is the mixture of alkaline atom of lithium and alkaline earth-like atom of yttrium. As you know, the lithium is a very nice alkali atom, which is widely used for the study of fermionic superfluidity and also the Bose-Einstein condensate with tunable interaction. In addition, the yttrium has also several unique features, such as the rich variety of isotopes and also the long existence of the long-lived metastable triplet P state, as well as the spin singlet ground state. And so far, there are several alkali-alkali mixture, alkali-alkali dimers, and also there are several yttrium isotope mixture, but there was no alkali and alkaline earth-like atom mixture so far in the quantum degenerate regime. Therefore, the yttrium lithium is the first example of such a combination of quantum gas. And this lithium yttrium mixture has several unique features. The first one is its large mass ratio. It's about 24. Quite large. And because of this, this mixture is useful for the study of the simulation of the infinity problem. Especially interesting is the system of the optical lattice, because yttrium is heavy, and so it is well localized in the optical lattice site, while the lithium is right and well delocalized over the entire lattice site. And we think that with this system, we can study the Anderson localization, for example. But in this case, random potential is generated by randomly distributed yttrium atoms rather than optical spectral field used in the previous works. Therefore, by manipulating the internal state of the yttrium atoms, we can dynamically control the random potential. This is an interesting possibility in the study of the Anderson localization. And we think that it is very important to study the randomness and superfluidity. This is sometimes called a problem of Anderson versus Anderson, which means that for weak random potential, the Anderson theorem tells us that the Cooper pair is robust against impurity, and TC doesn't change by impurity. But for a strong enough random potential, then Anderson localization occurs and TC decreases by impurity. And such a study is also important for deeper understanding of the phase diagram of the cuprate high TC superconductor, because randomness plays an important role in the so-called underdoped region, like this. And large mass ratio also offers a unique possibility in the study of the amphimorph trimer. This point was also discussed in the Pascal's talk in this morning session. And this theory predicts that a discrete scaling factor which characterizes the energy structure of the amphimorph trimer is only about 4 to 6 for lithium, yttrium, ytterbium trimer. This is in good contrast with the case of the identical boson, which has about 23. So the dense energy structure of the amphimorph trimer is an interesting possibility. It becomes possible with the when we're working with the lithium yttrium trimer. In addition to the large mass ratio, the existence of the electron spin degrees of freedom in the ground state of the yttrium lithium molecule is another unique feature. This point was also pointed out briefly in the Axel's talk for yttrium rubidium molecule. And similarly, this molecule is useful for the quantum simulation of the lattice spin model, which was proposed in this theoretical paper. And so the yttrium lithium mixture has several unique possibilities in several important applications. Okay, next I will describe in detail our recent experiment of realizing the quantum degenerate mixture of yttrium and lithium. Our experiment starts from the Zeeman's drawing of both of the yttrium and lithium atomic beams from the same orbit. And Zeeman's rod atoms are captured by a bichromatic magnet optical trap, like this. Especially for yttrium, the MOT is operated with the weak intercombination transition, which gives a lower Doppler cooling limit. And with this setup, we could successfully trap both of the lithium and yttrium in the MOT, like this. As I mentioned, the temperature of yttrium is lower than lithium due to the lower Doppler cooling limit. And the next step is the transfer of the atoms in the MOT into the optical trap, optical dipole trap. In this experiment, we used optical trap beam with these parameters, and maximum trap depth for lithium is about 2.5 millikelvin, and the maximum trap depth for yttrium is 1.3 millikelvin. And with this setup, we could successfully transfer the mixture from the MOT into the optical dipole trap, like this. Okay, and the optically trapped mixture is evaporatively cooled to quantum degeneracy by reducing the optical laser intensity. For this purpose, we also apply the vertical optical trapping beam for tight confinement to avoid the interference between these two beams. We use the different wavelengths, slightly different wavelengths for vertical optical trapping beam. And since the trap depth is shallower for yttrium, than for lithium, the evaporation predominantly occurs for ytterbium. And lithium is sympathetically cooled with the evaporatively cooled ytterbium. And evaporative cooling works well for ytterbium for these isotopes because the scattering lengths are relatively large. And this is a result of the sympathetic evaporative cooling. Here you can see the temperature of the ytterbium and lithium are almost the same during the evaporative cooling. And after about 12 second evaporation, we could reach the quantum degenerate regime for the mixture. And this is a result for the Bose-Fermi mixture. And in this case, lithium 6 has two spin components, like this. And while the ytterbium 174 is a spinless boson. And here you can see the lithium temperature is very low and deep in the Fermi degenerate regime. And the temperature of the lithium and ytterbium are almost the same. Therefore, the ytterbium atoms offer the good thermometry for this very cold Fermi gas of lithium 6. This is another advantage of this system. Okay, this is the case of the Fermi-Fermi mixture. Again, the lithium 6 has two spin components. And here, the ytterbium 173 has a six spin component because nuclear spin is 5 Hz. And this has a higher spin symmetry of SU6 because the scattering length doesn't change for different spin components. And therefore, this is another example of the Fermi-Fermi mixture, which has the SU2 and SU6 spin symmetry, which was previously obtained for the isotope mixture of ytterbium. Again, the lithium is deep in the Fermi degenerate regime, and temperature is very low because of the difference of the Fermi energy for lithium and ytterbium. Okay, so far, now we could obtain the quantum degenerate mixture of ytterbium and lithium, but how about the scattering grains between the ytterbium and lithium? And from the cross thermalization measurement between ytterbium 174 and lithium 6, we could get the information about the scattering lengths. In the case of the pure lithium or pure ytterbium, temperature doesn't change in the optical trap like this. However, in the case of the mixture, the temperature of the lithium decreases toward the temperature of the ytterbium. From this time constant, we could determine the absolute value of the scattering range between lithium 6 and ytterbium 124 as about 1 nanometer. And this value is consistent with the result obtained by Washington University group within the error bar. And from the similar measurement for the lithium 6 and ytterbium 173, we could also determine the absolute value of the scattering grains as about 0.9 nanometer. Okay. The scattering lengths are almost the same for these different isotope pairs. This is not accidental and can be explained by mass scaling analysis of the scattering lengths. I will not describe the detail of this formula, but essential point is that the reduced mass of this atom pair is mainly determined by lithium 6 and does not change by yttrium isotopes. Therefore, the phase phi in the expression in the scattering lengths doesn't change for yttrium isotopes. Therefore, the scattering lengths takes almost the same value for all the yttrium isotopes. This is the result of the mass scaling analysis of the scattering lengths. And therefore, we may well expect that the sympathetic evaporative cooling between lithium and yttrium works similarly well for all the yttrium isotopes. In this work, we used this boson and this fermion, but we have more boson like this, and also one more Fermi degenerate gas. And more exotic is the possibility of the three species mixtures, like this, and this, and this. And these mixtures are within the reach of our current experimental technology. Okay, finally, I will discuss the prospect of our research. And we plan to use yttrium lithium mixture for various experiments. And several applications need resonant variation of the yttrium lithium scattering lengths. And quite recently, the magnetic feedback resonance for yttrium lithium was discussed in this paper by Jeremy Hudson's group. And this is the interatomic interaction. And this term represents the modification of the lithium hyperfine coupling due to the yttrium, which give rise to the magnetic feedback resonance. But the resonance is barely narrow. It's only less than 10 micrograms. So it is very difficult to use of this resonance. But there is another term. This term represents the hyperfine coupling between the lithium electron spin and yttrium nuclear spin. This term also gives rise to a magnetic feedback resonance with a wider width. And this is a result of their calculation. And the width is much broader than this case, but still on the order of 1 milligauss, very narrow, unfortunately. And the resonant magnetic field is on the order of 1 kilogauss. So it's very difficult to use. But anyway, we searched for the feedback resonance, but of course, we couldn't find any resonance so far. 10 to the minus 6 stability of a magnetic field is experimentally challenging. But this is not the end of the story, but we think that a possibility of using RF field-induced feedback resonance might relax this constraint by shifting the resonant magnetic field to lower value. This is an interesting possibility of this system. And in addition, we are now implementing the optical relative setup for ytterbium lithium mixture. When we use the optical lattice beam with the wavelength of 1064 nanometer, for example, then lithium and ytterbium occupy the same lattice site. This is a normal optical lattice configuration. On the other hand, when we use the 532 nanometer laser light, then for optical lattice, then lithium and ytterbium occupy the different position in the optical lattice site. This is also an interesting situation of the optical lattice. For both cases, the trap depth divided by recoil energy, so-called S parameter, is larger for ytterbium for both cases. So the ytterbiums are rather well localized in the optical lattice, and the lithium is well delocalized. So as I mentioned in the introduction, this system is very useful for the study of the Anderson localization, so-called binary alloy model. And some theorists suggest that this system is useful for the study of the park ratio of the localization rather than sudden Anderson localization. So this is an interesting possibility which can be studied with this system. And use of the two electron atom of ytterbium offers another interesting possibility, namely the probing of lithium superfluidity by a high-resolution spectroscopy of ytterbium. As shown here, there are long-lived metastable triple P state. And between the ground state and the triple P state, there are only weakly allowed intercombination transitions, which would be useful for high-resolution laser spectroscopy, as was the case of the RF spectroscopy for alkaline atoms. And this is an example of such a high-resolution spectroscopy for pure ytterbium in optical lattice in the MOT insulating regime. These three peaks correspond to the singly occupied site and the doubly occupied site and excitation to the higher band. So we believe that with this technique, we can sensitively probe the behavior of the lithium-6 superfluidity. Okay, and this is a new experimental setup for optical lattice of ytterbium lithium. And so far, we could successfully trap the ytterbium atoms with the optical dipole trap like this. And also, we have almost finished implementing the optical lattice setup with 1064 nanometer wavelengths. So we hope we can start the optical lattice experiment for ytterbium lithium mixture quite soon. Okay, and the electric dipole moment is an important parameter for study of the dipolar physics using molecule. And this ITAMP group calculated the interatomic potential and also the electric dipole moment in the electronic ground state, the calculated value is unusually small. So it is very difficult to perform the dipolar physics using this small value of the dipole moment. However, the possibility of using a metastable electronic molecular state correlating with this state is explored by the same group. Their tentative calculations show that the dipole moment is as large as the 4 to 7 divide. So this might offer alternative route to the study of the dipole physics using this molecule. Okay, and finally, I will mention that the recent theoretical paper point out that the molecular transition of this molecular transition of ytterbium lysine is a good candidate of the frequency standard terahertz regime because of the existence of the far off resonant magic wavelengths which cancel the molecular light shift. Okay, this is the summary of my talk. And I reported the experimental realization of the quantum degenerate mixture of ytterbium and lithium. And I discussed the several prospects of our research. And this is finally, I will introduce our group members. In particular, these four people are working very hard for the ytterbium lysine project. In addition, we acknowledge the collaboration and useful discussion with these people. So thank you very much for attention.
So, questions. Hori.
Okay, I have two questions. The first one is I didn't get the basic idea of how to probe the lithium-6 superfluidity in the two spin states using the ytterbium atoms. The ytterbium atom will be weakly interacting with the superfluid, and so I don't understand what the basic idea is. And okay.
Because this spectrum has a very narrow line with this, so it is sensitively, we can sensitively detect the broadening or shifting of the this spectral position, this resonance. And it might be different for the single occupied side and double occupied side, also a higher band. So from this change of the spectrum, we believe that we can get the information about the lithium interaction. But of course, we need to know the interaction between the lithium and a metastable ytterbium for different spectroscopic data.
Second question, I mean, you suggested because of this dipole moment problem and this combination to work with ytterbium atoms in a higher state, and then you will have molecules not being really in the ground state, and the question is then you open up inelastic decay channels. Is there a good reason to think that they are very strongly suppressed?
I'm not sure. But this group also calculated the lifetime of the state, but did not. I think the inelastic decay channel was not considered yet. But yes, yeah, you are right. We need to be careful about such a process.
So So you want to use ytterbium as impurities in optical lattice? What species would be most favorable, a bosonic one, a fermionic one, or does it not matter for you?
I think it doesn't matter.
And how to get the ytterbium randomly distributed?
We need some trick, because we can prepare the filling one multi-insulator state with no randomness. Then we think that some heating would occur, some heating would cause the beta in the multi-insulator state. It might be considered as a random change, or by inducing the lattice modulation technique, then we can also produce some randomness in the multi-insulator state.
Okay, further questions? Francesca?
Just a curiosity, because you mentioned the possibility of shifting the flashback resonance to lower magnetic field using a radio frequency approach. So how much can you shift? So what's the realistic? So where do you think you can go somehow?
I think in principle, we can shift to any value of the magnetic field. But we can choose the RF frequency for a coupling between the open channel and closed channel. But of course, we need a careful estimation of the coupling, lobby frequency, for useful feedback resonance.
Sorry, suppose that you don't care about magnetic flashback resonances at the first order and you want to do this Anderson localization thing you were saying with just the background scattering length between lithium-6 and ytterbium. So if you just look again at the Hamiltonian you would like to investigate, you have let's say, yeah, exactly, you have J, U, and W. with realistic numbers, with the background scattering length,
yes.
How much W can be compared to U and J?
If we could have a deep optical lattice, tight confinement without in a sizable random potential, which give rise to localization effect. Yeah, 1 nanometer is enough to produce the localization effect by our estimation.
So, Carlos, yes, 1 second.
So it seems to me that you can have these two geometries here, which you analyze. But could you also, in principle, have a geometry in which you optically trap the ytterbium and just have the lithium, using different laser, perhaps different lasers, and have lithium in a just a harmonic trap?
We first create the mixture in a 1064 nanometer optical trap. Then we adiabatically load into the lattice by 532 nanometer resonance. Then.
Yeah, but I was wondering if you could have the instead of having both species in optical potential, I mean in optical lattices trapped in an optical lattice, you could have choose a laser in which you would create an optical lattice for the ytterbium, just load it lightly so it looked like impurities, and embedded there, you have a trap for lithium, and a harmonic trap for lithium that does not see the lattice. I mean, what I'm trying to do is say, well, you have the superfluid lithium immersed in that sea of impurities, and you can ask the Anderson versus Anderson also if you can tune the lithium-lithium interaction. Huh? I'm not so sure if it is not, but the point I'm trying to make is there a laser that you can get ytterbium as impurities in a lattice, and the lithium atoms do not see the lattice. They are in a harmonic trap. Because the examples you're giving, both of them are in lattices, right?
Yes, this is the case of the very deep optical lattice. Not in a sufficiently deep optical lattice, then lithium would be devaporized. But,
okay, we can talk.
Well, just a comment from my side. I mean, if you look at the right there, for these parameters, I mean, it's a factor of 25, yeah?
No,
okay.
So
it's... It's free. It's free. I mean, if you go to a reasonable lattice depth, yeah, 20 recall or so,
right, so
and lithium.
Yeah, of course. Okay.
Yes. Okay, any further questions? If not, we'll thank the speaker again.